Hello, what's up guys? Welcome back to my channel. In this video, we will be talking about the Banila and Coal Balm Cleanser. This is the Clean It Zero Balm to Oil Cleanser. Best Korean balm cleanser in the world. It's actually one of the OG. So I personally have tried the original one before. It definitely cleans the makeup so well. Like even the toughest type of makeup that you have, it does the job super well. But for this video in particular, I'm not going to be focusing on that. I'm not going to be focusing on showing you like, okay, whether or not it removes tough makeup, my eyeliner or anything. More importantly, in this video, I want to test out the four that I have here and see what's the difference. Are they really different from each other? Like for example, I have four here. One is the original one. One is the revitalizing one. One is the purifying one. And another one is the nourishing one. How different are they from each other? Are they like, for example, the nourishing one? Is it definitely more hydrating and more moisturizing and more nourishing as compared to like the purifying and the revitalizing one, purifying one? Does it feel more clean as compared to the original one? So that's gonna be the focus of this video. I love it when brands actually come out with like mini kits for us to be able to just try everything, or even just buy it because of like traveling purposes or anything like that. Little tube of this is 7 ml. Here I pretty much lay out from the least moisturizing to the most moisturizing kinda ish. So let's start with the purifying first. It doesn't have much scent to it. Scent is closest to the original one. Also melts really easily, glides nicely on the skin. But when it comes to rinsing it off, I definitely do feel like this kind of stripped off a little bit more as compared to any one of the other range. This one definitely cleans your face a little bit better. It definitely leaves your skin feeling a little bit more clean, which also means that it kind of is less moisturizing on the face. That's what it says, like it kind of purifies the skin and kind of cleans better. So if you have like maybe oily skin type, this is definitely one that you want to use if you want a cleansing balm. Now next up, cleansing balm revitalizing one. The scent is quite strong, like it's a very fruity scent for sure, but balm itself, it's very similar to the original balm as well. It kind of melts onto your skin, it applies quite nicely, massage very nicely. When it comes to cleaning wise, I feel like it's somewhere in between the purifying one and the original one. It leaves the skin feeling clean but at the same time not too drying. I would definitely still feel like I would want to apply my moisturizer after using the revitalizing one for sure, but at least like it's not an immediate thing where I feel like, oh, my skin is kind of thirsting for hydration. It's just that the scent is actually very strong. This is not some scent that I feel everybody will like. So if you want something that's a little bit more mild in terms of scent but you still want a clean feeling, then you should go for the purifying one. It has less scent. The scent is like almost no scent at all, really. That's the difference. I feel like if you want to leave your skin feeling more clean, these two would be to go for. But if you want something with less scent, then you should go for the purifying one. In terms of ones that can moisturize and nourish your skin, these two are definitely the one to go, the original one and the nourishing one. But I would say that in terms of like nourishing feeling, I don't thing that is too much of a difference. This, the yellow one, is supposed to be the more nourishing one. It does a little bit better in terms of leaving your skin feeling moisturized. It does just a little bit better than the pink one. Pink one itself, to be honest, also, it leaves your skin feeling nice and moisturized. Like, it doesn't strip off your skin completely. They still remove waterproof makeup and shit like that. Maybe just a little bit more nourishing, then you can use the yellow one. So these two, definitely when after rinsing it off, I don't feel like my skin is tight or anything. I don't feel like I need to rush off immediately to get my moisturizer. But in terms of scent, the yellow one definitely has a pretty strong like honey scent. But if you want something that's like less scented, you should go for a pink one. So it really boils down to what kind of scent that you like also. I think the pricing wise is also about the same. I don't think there's much of a difference in terms of pricing. And in terms of sensitivity wise, like for me, I have sensitive skin. Basically anyone of these Clean It Zero I can actually use without feeling like it's causing any issue on my face at all. So these are the Clean It Zero cleansing balms and these are my review of them. Which one you should you pick, it really depends on your skin type. Just know your skin type and you know which one to pick basically. Obviously Banila and Co cleansing balm is OG. I definitely always will go back to it, but I do want to try out some other cleansing balm moving forward for sure, like the Hamish one I think, and then also the Beauty of Chasson one. We'll see how. That's all for this video. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoy. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.
Don't forget to like and subscribe. Today's gonna be a good day. Wake up. 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 Today's gonna be a good day.